Andy Emilio for ES News. We're here with Leonard Ellebre, CEO, Mayweather Promotions. Mayweather Promotions is super hot right now. I was talking to Rollies yesterday. He's going viral. Knockouts everywhere. The future, the present, everything sports entertainment. What's going on? What can we expect from Mayweather Promotions going forward?
We have a huge card tomorrow night. We got three of our youngsters fighting on the card. Starting out with Dylan Price.
Right, first up,
very
on
excited
to the
with,
scale.
His, with his future lies
ahead. The animal.
Exciting young fighter. Miguel. Can't wait to see him tomorrow. We got Richardson Hitchens.
Mm-hmm.
Everybody know about Africa.
Yep.
Can't wait to see him get in there, do his thing tomorrow. And then we got Ron Rowder. He's opening up the card tomorrow on the
Miguel
on Showtime.
Miguel is 0.2 pounds
broadcast.
Over the 140
very
pound
excited
limit.
For his fight with our
he will re-weigh.
Big night for Mayweather Promotions tomorrow. And then we have next event is the Charlo
Harrison
fight,
mm-hmm.
June 23rd. And then we're doing another dark show in Sam Sound on the 29th. June, Manny Pacquiao fight, July, lots of big things coming up.
Just Manny Pacquiao fight. And Keith Thurman, that's a big fight.
Huge
mega fight.
Huge.
Everyone's going to want to know, will that fight be the one to bring Floyd back into it?
No
way possible.
No.
Keith Thurman can't entice him, Manny Pacquiao can't entice him.
140 on the dot for Miguel, 140 pounds for Miguel.
He had a wonderful career, and I has nothing
and
else
now
to
his opponent, once again,
has Floyd given even like a little bit of who he thinks might win that fight as a prediction? Or does
no.
he even, is he even on his radar?
I don't even think Floyd knows that they fight.
Okay, all right. Does Leonard Ellebre have, not a prediction, because obviously you're on the promotion, but how do you see that fight playing out considering Thurman's last performance?
I don't think that you can take that last performance into consideration. Keith Thurman is an outstanding fighter. He has been off for almost 2 years. So coming back, you know, I don't really think we can put too much energy into the fight with Lopez. Keith's a tough fighter. He's called one time for a reason.
Yeah.
He brings it, and we all know what Manny Pacquiao brings to the table. Very, very exciting fight for the fans.
Manny Pacquiao had his last outing with Adrian Broner. That was also right there under the Mayweather Promotions banner. How cool is it that after everything that happened with Floyd and Manny, now you guys are promoting the Manny Pacquiao card?
It's a great honor to be working with a Hall of Famer who's a legend still in this sport. There's nothing but great things to say about
once again, thank you, ladies and gentlemen, for coming on.
Everything
out
he's
to
done
our
for his
weigh-ins.
Country
don't forget,
and what he's continued to still do.
Here
he's still a
Brooklyn,
great fighter.
From
you know, wish him the best. Should be a great fight.
Do you and Manny ever joke behind the scenes about past stuff with Floyd and everything like that?
No, our relationship is a little different. Not we both have a mutual respect. He's really a fun guy. You know, behind the scenes, you know, we have a very cool relationship.
Now Tank's supposed to have a homecoming fight, right?
Yes.
Soon? Yes. So,
July 27th.
One of the biggest names in the sport of boxing, Gervonta Davis. He's always on social media. Everybody wants to see the big fights. When are we going to see him? Maybe Tevin Farmer? Somebody mix it up. What's going to have to happen for that to happen?
Well, first, he's got to get through his mandate on July 27th. And you can never take any fighter for granted. So let's hopefully he can get through that. And then we look to the big picture.
Yeah.
And the first thing we're looking to do is unify.
Okay.
Come the fall. The very first thing we're looking to do is unify. And if we're unable to do that, there's no secret to some of the names who called him out. Whether it be
Gary Russell hasn't been shy. He's been saying he wants that fight.
Joe Santa Cruz.
Yeah.
Abner Morris. Whether it could be
Gary Russell.
Gary Russell. It doesn't matter. You know, we'll make the biggest fight possible for Gervonta Davis.
Now, I know
first
before.
First things first, though.
Yeah.
That ticket has been July 27th.
July 27th, absolutely. You got to take care of business. How do we see the bigger fights get made? If, by unification, I assume you meant him and Tevin Farmer, right? That's the unification, right?
Yeah, definitely.
So, how does that happen, being that he's on the zone and all that kind of stuff?
No,
what
Tevin
has to happen?
Tevin Farmer's with Lou DiBella.
Okay.
That's
so,
his promoter.
Okay.
Yeah, and I know that he's working with the zone with Eddie Hearn, who's also an excellent promoter. again, we're all those big fights the fans want to see, they're going to happen.
Money talks, right? It's just going to happen, have to happen. Networks, whoever gives
Tank
the biggest.
Tank talks.
There you go.
Tank talks. Tank is the money.
Yeah.
That's there why you they're chasing him.
The ultimate super fight, obviously, Tank and Lomachenko at some point in time.
We don't know that. We don't know that. I mean, the super fight could be any and every fight that he fights if it's in a big fight.
That's the truth. Yeah.
You know, Tank is the guy. He's the guy. All roads lead through Tank.
Tank has to voice his opinion sometimes, though, right? Like behind the scenes. Does, you know, does Tank have a list?
Tank voices his opinion all the time. Mm. He wants to fight all those guys.
Yeah.
But again, you can't fight everybody
in
one night.
Can't do it. Can't do
it. Gotta line them up. And that's what we're doing. Line them all up. They all gonna get it.
What's Floyd up to nowadays?
He'll be here tomorrow.
Oh, he'll be here tomorrow?
Yeah, Floyd will be here tomorrow.
What's Floyd's impression of the Bronze Bomber, Deontay Wilder?
He all thinks they're all great fighters.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Is there a fighter that he looks at in boxing that he actually gets him excited? Because I know it's hard to be excited when you were like the guy who was number one pound
all
for pound.
All of them were the promotion fighters. Yeah, so they get him excited.
Makes sense, makes sense. Leonard, appreciate your time as always. Thank you so much.
Thank you.